Welcome to Your Two Cents, where we give you our opinion, then ask for yours. Now, you may have heard that Jay-Z will be giving away 1 million copies of his upcoming album, Magna Carta Holy Grail, to his fans, provided they download a specific app, and provided they own a Samsung Galaxy S3, S4, or Galaxy Note 2. Yeah, this is a cross-promotional thingy that's supposed to get us all excited about the new album and a new series of phones. But my question is buying a new phone too much for this kind of reward? How far have you guys gone or would you go to get something free? And how much personal attention, time, or information are you willing to trade to get that free stuff?
I'm not a Jay-Z fan, but I'll probably download the app.
Oh, right.
You have a Galaxy, right?
Yeah. I do. I've got an S3, so I'm already a third of the way there.
Nice.
So, yeah, I'd totally download it just... I mean, I don't even like Jay-Z, but hey, it's a free album.
Right. Now, you went out of your way. You knew this was going to happen, so you bought a Galaxy S3, correct?
I've been planning for this album for the last 2 years.
This was planned, yes.
No, actually, not at all.
Yeah, I definitely wouldn't go as far as to buy a phone for anyone's album. Even to be honest with you, the whole app part, like, I don't think I would download an app just for a free album. I don't know.
No.
I guess, what's the app asking me to do? You know, is it taking my info? Is it going to get access to my, you know,
right,
to my photos, to my calls, to my texts, whatever? I don't know. I'm a little hesitant about that.
Well, that's one thing that information is kind of light on, is we're not really sure what the app is going to do, but I'm sure it's probably going to give you, like, behind-the-scenes stuff, maybe some extra cuts or B-sides to some songs. I don't think it's going to be anything nefarious, you know? It's like, now Jay-Z owns all of your text messages.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, here's the question I have. What would stop you from downloading the app, getting the album, and then deleting the app?
Nothing.
Right.
The way that I've taken the information is that there's nothing to stop you from doing that. They just want you to install that app. But I think that they're hoping that there's going to be more to the app that'll cause you to stick around, you know? It's like, oh, well, you install the app to get the free album. Then you notice that you're going to see video clips from Jay-Z and, like, personal messages. Maybe he's going to release some things through the app, so you'll keep it around, you know?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Well, we'll have to see. Well,
yeah.
Now, when's it due out?
The app is going to be on the 24th, and the album drops on July 4th, but if you have the app, you can get access to it on July 1st, but you have to be one of the first million people to try and download it through the app. But let's get back to trading what we have or our time for free things. What's the most you've ever traded for something free? I'll give you an example. In college, I signed up for a couple of credit cards because I would get a free T-shirt with them. Now, I wore that T-shirt to death, but it did not outlast the debt that I put on the card. What about you guys? How far have you gone for something free?
Definitely the credit card T-shirt. Actually, I got a water bottle out of it.
Uh-huh. Which is
really?
Probably
That's
more
pretty
useful
good.
And would last longer than a T-shirt. You know?
But every now and then we'll do deals on give us your name and address and you'll get like a year's worth of Men's Health or a year's worth of like Fast Company or whatever magazine. I've done that before.
Right.
I guess I'm not really too wild about it because like now that I think of it, maybe all that spam mail that I'm getting is because of that.
Right.
You know? But yeah, I think that's probably as far as I'll go.
I'll give away all my information for just about anything. You know, it's as long as they're not stealing my credit cards or anything like that, I don't care. They can have it all. If I get a free McRib sandwich out of the deal, I'm good. If I get, you know, if I get a T-shirt, that's awesome. I think the speaking of college, what did I do? I remember signing up for a Visa card when I first went to school, and I got a set of knives out of the deal.
Mm. Wow,
it was actually pretty good. It was
dangerous.
Yeah, I know. I was sitting there wondering in retrospect, wow, what are they trying to promote here?
Yeah. So it sounds like essentially what we're all saying is that we like free stuff that we get by being passive, whereas like we can sit in our chair and we could put in some information and they'll send us something. We're not really, none of us are going to jump into a car and drive miles just because we can get like a free ice cream cone or something like that.
Right.
We don't want to put the effort into these kinds of things, right? Is that
right.
What we're saying?
Yeah,
I'll
for
go,
the most
I'll go
part.
With that.
Yeah, for the most part, I like when it comes to like, you know, like us on Facebook and get like a $3 credit or tweet this, like Amazon does this, tweet this to get like a $3, $2 MP3 credit. That's when I'm like, no, you know what? If you want to use my account as a billboard, you're going to have to up the stakes. Sorry. You
yeah.
know,
Interesting. Yeah,
Those I don't do.
See, I'm totally on board with those because I like it, I get the credit, I unlike it, or I tweet it, I get the credit, and then I delete the tweet, you know?
Oh, so you unlike it after it.
Oh, yeah, I immediately unlike and unfollow. I'm the person that they don't want to get these types of credits, you know? Well, that's our 2 cents. Viewers, what's yours? How far are you willing to go to get something for free? Let us know in the comments below. I'm Jeff Sumagee. Goodbye.